It's a privilege to be here with you. Carmela, how are you? You're so quiet. Please have a seat. Spasiba. Wow. I'm so privileged to be with you here. I came here to your country for the first time 35 years ago when it was still the Soviet Union. I was invited by the Soviet government with a group of scientists who were studying paranormal activities, psychic abilities. And I was doing firewalking, so they invited me, and I had the unique opportunity of being here in those days and traveling here from Moscow all the way to Siberia on Siberian train and meeting so many people. And during that time, coming here is such a beautiful thing. I feel so lucky because this was 1983. I was 23 years old. I was just starting my career. And I remember I stopped in a town outside Siberia and bought this giant Soviet map. And on the back, I laid out my plan on the back of the map of how I was going to conquer the world and serve millions of people. It was the beginning of my journey. I came back again 9 years later in 1992, after you formed the Russian Federation, and things had changed. I had the privilege of flying MiG jets. You were making that offer, they brought me over, and I got to go on a high-level interceptor of yours at 76,000 feet, where I looked up and saw the space, I looked down and saw the sunlight, I could see the curvature of the Earth. I was traveling almost twice the speed of sound in one of your MiG jets. I went to Space City and had an opportunity to be in the zero gravity there as well. And so it's such a unique opportunity to come back here to visit with you today, where now I am 35 years later at 58 years old, and I've had the privilege now of working around the world with 50 million people from 100 countries, and I have some things that I can really share that I think can make a significant difference for the quality of your life. And so I want to thank you, first of all, for the privilege of coming here, because you have no idea what you're getting yourself into, and you've come here. So thank you. Please give a hand to everyone. Gregory and Gail and Synergy University for bringing me here. And I tell you how excited I am to be here, because last night I got in late and I went out to go to Red Square, and because I guess all the advertisements and so forth, I was stopped by so many people. I met so many beautiful Russian people last night, took hundreds of pictures of people and got to talk to them in my English and a little bit of broken Russian. And so it's very exciting. I know it's an interesting time for you. First of all, beautiful to see your city continue to grow and see. I watched the World Cup and I saw congratulations when you guys beat Spain finally. It was really beautiful to see. And yes, give a hand with that for sure. And also, I know it's a time of uncertainty because, you know, inflation is kind of scary at times, could come back. I know there's volatility in economies all over the world right now, not just in Russia. And so I know that can produce uncertainty about what are you going to do? How's the world going to work? Part of what I've worked on for the last basically 41 years of my life, I've looked at what are the tools, what are the strategies that can help you succeed in life and business in the shortest period of time. And what I found is there's some very simple tools that can make that difference. I've learned over time, I used to make things very complex because it made me feel intelligent. But what I learned was complexity is the enemy of execution. When you make things too complex, nobody does it. And so I thought maybe before we do anything else, I might show you just real quickly why the rich get richer and the poor get poorer. Why successful people tend to succeed even more and people fail tend to fail even more. Why happy people tend to get more happy. How many found that happy people tend to get happier and sad people get more sad? How many can relate to this here? Say ah! Or ah! Right? And by the way, in this event, when we're working together, there's a challenge when you first go to start in the first time doing teaching in a community like this. And that is most of us in this room have been trained by a 20th century school. In a 20th century school, what you learned to do was you learned to report to your desk, to your chair, a bell usually rang, and when you got there, you were supposed to sit down and be quiet. Don't do anything until someone tells you to do it. And don't talk to your neighbor. But in the real world today, if you're in business and you don't talk to your labor, you're out of business. If you wait for someone to tell you what to do, you'll never succeed. How many agree with me? Say that. And so when you learn in a passive way, which is the way we've all been trained to learn, what happens is whatever you're learning tends to get attached to the energy you had when you were learning it. So if you're sitting here passively, as we've all learned to learn, and quietly, and you're all being very nice to me, you've all come here and you're being wonderful and giving me the gift of your attention. But if you sit like this for the whole time, quietly, then when you learn things, whatever you learn will get attached to that energy. How many of you in this room, if I may ask, have been to a learning environment before where you learned something that you truly thought was valuable? No one was selling you. You said, this is really helpful to me. It could have been the university, it could have been in school, it could have been a seminar. And you learned something, you thought, this could help me in my life or my business. But then when you went home, you never applied what you learned. How many have done this before? If you have, please raise your hand and say that. Say that. Who's done this more than once in your lifetime? Say that. Who still feels intelligent? Say that. So the question is, why would smart people like us who work hard, we spend our time, energy, and money to learn and get excited about something and then never apply it? The reason is because of this passive learning. So I want to make sure, how many of you came today to change something, improve something significantly in your business or your life? If you did, please yell back. Thank you, Spasiba. Because if we're going to get real results, we can't do it in this passive way. That's why people go to seminars. The reason that I've been able to travel around the world and work with more than 50 million people, from the greatest athletes, billionaire entrepreneurs, to kids, is because I know how to get results. Results don't come from being passive. And yet we're trained to be passive. And many of you, you're being very passive and still enjoying yourself. You could be sitting here going, this is interesting, or that could be really useful, or I'm really gonna do this later. But if you do it in this state, later on you're gonna feel like I really should do this. But if we, and even if you're having a good time, even if you're sitting here right now and you're having a good time and you're looking at me and saying, damn, he has big teeth, whatever you're thinking, if you don't put energy into it, there'll be no action later on. Does this make sense? Yes or no? Yes or no? Awesome. Because here's what research shows. If you sit and listen to me passively, the way we've all been trained to learn, within 30 days you'll remember 10% of what we talked about today, which would be a waste of your time. I don't want to waste your time. I didn't come here to waste your time. At the same time, if you listen and take notes, even if you never read the notes again, research shows you'll retain, you'll use 40 to 50% a month from now. Because just writing it down drives the groove deeper. So I encourage you to write down. But the most powerful way is to use your body. If you raise your hand, if you know out the answers, if you move your body, if you interact with different people, research shows you retain 90 to 95%. How many want to really leave here with real results here? Say I. Spasiba. So then what we want to do is create more energy in this room, because otherwise you're going to nod and have a good time and go home and do nothing. But if we use our bodies in a different way, we'll get different results. If you do what you've done in the past, you get the same results, but if you do something different, you'll get greater results. And so we're going to use our bodies as part of that tool to make it happen. So, because without energy, There is no follow through. Many people have great intention, but they don't do anything because they don't follow through. So I like to start, since the energy in this room is very subdued, by trying something a little different. First, question for you. How important is energy to success in business? On a scale from 0 to 10, where 10 is the most important and 0 is not important at all, where would you put it? How many would put it 8 or above? If you would, raise your hand and say, ah. Awesome. How many think it's a 9 on a 0 to 10? Say, ah. How many think it's a 10 of importance? Say, ah. I do too. So think about this. Without energy, there's no follow through. Without energy, there's no change. Without energy, there's nothing. If you have two people in a relationship, forget business for a moment, in an intimate relationship, and they both love each other completely, truly in love, and they're both in super high energy states. I call those peak states of energy, peak states of joy. When two people love each other and they have huge energy, what kind of relationship will they have? Good, lousy, or great? What would you say, nice and loud in your own language? Come on, give it up. Yes, it would be great. Now watch this. If you have two people love each other in peak high energy, energy-rich states, great relationship. What if you have the same two people, but their energy is okay? Not super high, not bad, just okay. And they love each other just as much. Will they have the same level of passion, same level of aliveness in that relationship? Da or yet? Yeah. And yet they love each other just as much, true? What if you take these two people who love each other equally, and because of work, because of problems with kids, because of being tired, because of problems with family, maybe financial stress, they let their energy drop very low. And they still love each other, but their energy is really low. Same two people. Good relationship, great relationship, or problems in the relationship? Which one? Nice and loud in your language, please. How many think there are going to be problems in this relationship, even though they love each other? If so, raise your hand and say, nah. So, what I want you to understand is energy is everything. So here's the question. If energy is so important, then why? Why, if energy is so important, where did we get it from? Because we need it in this room right now. We all say it's 8, 9, or 10. So where do we find the energy? Someone, anyone here tell me, where do we find the energy? Oh, someone speaks English. Someone said food. Food? Come on. Energy is a source of food, but energy isn't really. Food is not the energy source. How many of you can remember a holiday when you were together with family and you ate lots of food? How many can remember a holiday like that? So I know you're hearing me and understanding me. Thank you so much. Say, ah. At the end of that holiday, how much do you eat when you're on a holiday like that? A little or a lot? A lot. And when you eat a lot of food, afterwards you say, I'll never eat again. And then someone says, dessert? And you go, okay. But at the end of that, do you feel like going for a run or working out? Or do you feel like taking sleep or a nap? Which one do you need to do? Tell me, come on. That's right. And by the way, I'm asking you the questions, and I'm wanting your answers, not because you don't know the answer. But if you listen to me passively, you'll have the same result as before. But if you yell the answer, your energy will grow, and the room's energy will grow. Who's willing to do this? Raise your hand and say, that. So, if we're going to make the changes that we really want, food is not it. In fact, have any of you in this room ever gone on a fast where you had no food for 3, 4, 5 days? Who's ever gone on a fast? Anyone done this for a week? When you go on a fast, does your energy decrease after the first couple days, or does it increase? Which one? It increases. So if food was a source of energy, then not eating should make you weak, and eating a lot should make you strong. Food is not the source of energy, don't get me wrong. Food's important, But if you want energy right now, food's not going to do it. What's the source? We want energy, and energy is so important because everything I'm going to tell you is worthless if you don't use it. And you won't use it unless you have enough energy. Does this make sense? So where do we get it if it's not food? Ah, someone said sleep. Who here has ever slept 8 hours and you're still tired? Raise your hand and say, nah. So have you ever had a time when you were very tired in the middle of the night and then something happened and it woke you up and then suddenly you wake for hours? Who's ever had this experience? Say, nah. So we're going to create that here if you're willing to. So I believe energy comes from psychology, from mindset. Energy is a habit. Most people have a habit of low energy. And because everybody else has so-so energy, they notice people lower than them and they feel good about themselves. But we have 20,000 people in this room, and it would be a waste of your time if you just sat here for 3 hours and listened to me. That's silly. I want to serve you. I came here today to find a way to add massive value to your life. You gave me the gift of your attention. You can get your money back, but you can't get your time back. I don't take it for granted you're giving me 4 hours, 3.5 hours of your time. By the way, my shortest seminar normally is 50 hours, 50 hours, 4 days and nights. I don't usually do something like this, but I came here because so many beautiful Russian people have flown around the world. We're going to stand, and you're going to find somebody, anybody, and you're going to point them and say, I own you, in your language. I own you. Or you can say it in English if you want. Well, you say, I own you. What you're saying is, I challenge you to have more energy, because I have more energy than you do. It's a game. How few in this room are competitive? How many of you are competitive people? You like competition. You like to succeed, you like to break through. If you do, say no! So in a moment, you're gonna pick a partner, you're gonna challenge them playfully, just a playful challenge. We'll do this throughout the day to get our energy up. And then when I'm ready, we'll say, I own you, no, I own you, I own you. Playfully. And then we're gonna go one, we're gonna count to three, we're gonna clap. One, two, and when I say three, we are going to shake the building with our energy. Stand up, please. Stand up.
We'll do it again. Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. And do it. And do it. And do it. Let's do it. And 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 do it. Let's 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 do it.
Someone point them and say, I own you. Say, no, I own you. Find a partner, say, I own you. Are you understanding me now? On three, we're going to clap together. One, two, and three. Your job is out through the energy, jumping and using your voice. Ready? I own you! No, I own you! One, pump it! Two! Three, go! Make some noise! Make some noise! Now watch. How many feel better than before? If you do, make a fist and say no. Now watch. This is what some people did. They went, I own it, yeah! And they went, oh, I'm so glad that's over. This crazy American, it's hot in here. Let me sit down. Now we get back to the seminar and stuff. See, sit up in your chair like you're in a command chair of your life. Sit up like you're in power, not like you're weak. Come, sit up. Feel the energy. And now, wake up the people beside you. Show the people on either side what high energy looks like by your example. Wake up your world beside you. Go! Come on! Wake them up!